I guess the most important thing to do before you go on tour is to kind of, you know, get your head together, get prepared for it, because there's a lot of stuff that goes into it. Like it's a lot of fun, and we always love it. But there's a lot of work too that you kind of have to, you know, get prepared for. And most of that comes from, you know, just missing your family and your friends back home. So you really kind of have to spend as much time as possible with them and just enjoy every second that you've got. And you know, I tend to play with dogs, my dogs in particular, and just kind of hang out with my family and friends, go to bars, go to pizza joints, whatever.
Thing about tour, well, it's a tough question because there's a lot of awesome things about tour. But if I had to pick one thing, I'd say my favorite thing about tour is seeing my friends that don't live in Florida, the ones that moved away to New York or California, and seeing them in like their new element, and just being able to hang out with them and them actually showing me around certain areas. So I'd have to say that's probably my favorite thing about tour.
So, something not a lot of people know about Matt over here. He used to be in a Misfits cover band back in the day. It's actually one of the first times I ever saw him play anything called Psycho 78.
You remember the name?
I do remember the name.
That's special to me. I was the singer.
He was. He'd get all dressed up in face paint. He had like his really, really long hair. And get on stage and just own it.
That was awesome. I love the Misfits. So the average day in the life of a Go Radio tour is fun. It's exciting and it's cool. It's new every day, I suppose, but at the same time, mildly redundant. I mean, you pretty much have the same schedule every day. I mean, usually when you wake up, it seems like most of us sleep in, except for the person driving or maybe one or two people who's awake. Everybody kind of wakes up when we get to the venue. And at that point, we pretty much wake up, you put your shoes on, you wipe the grogginess out of your eyes, and you instantaneously start lifting heavy equipment.
Yeah, I feel immediately. Like.
Immediately. So the first thing you do as soon as you wake up is lift heavy equipment, which is interesting. I guess it's a really quick way to wake up.
Well,
but
it's a terrific workout as well.
Yeah, it's a good way to shock your muscles right out the gate.
Yeah.
So we usually load in and, you know, you start setting your stuff up, and shortly thereafter it's, you know, you do the sound check and whatnot, and this usually happens all before you even have a bite to eat.
Yeah.
And so by the end of sound check,
you've yet to brush your teeth.
Yeah, so by the end of sound check, everyone's usually in a great mood by the end of sound check because nobody's eaten, nobody's brushed their
teeth. Everything's been really loud.
Yeah, everything, and you're playing loud music right out of the gate, but after that, usually I'll go out and grab a bite to eat and all that fun stuff. We like to look, and actually sometimes we ask people that are from the area or if we've been there before that venue, we know of the cool spots to eat, grab lunch, or sometimes we ask the promoters. And then usually as of lately we've spent a lot of time hanging out with the other bands. We usually like to hang out with the other bands, hang out in the parking lots. We always bring tons of those unfoldable camping chairs. And we set them up in a massive circle, and we bring cornhole boards, and we play. Yep, we play cornhole boards. Actually, Matt and Steve, I think, made them, which was really cool. They made them on tour once, and so we bring those everywhere, and we play. We have fun. Usually have a couple beers, and then showtime.
Yeah.
Usually
play the show, load out. Occasionally go to a bar or something afterwards, and just kind of hang out and wind down for a little bit, and then leave. Do it all over again the next day.
Yeah, and then you go to sleep, and you start all over again.